We're doing class. More recent acquisitions include a Sydney suburban double-decker S-set, a Lisbon grill constructed from a kit, and a Melbourne W5 class in the original unmodified form. This later footage, showing the tram room prettied up a bit, with the new HO sidings there on the screen, and a British double-deck tram car which I found in battered condition and freshened up with London colours. There's plenty of Melbourne representation, justifiably. And there's an R-class tram car in O gauge, built in Moscow, would you believe? The OPs were a rebuild of the O-class after heavy damage, and the first batch had matchboard sides which I've emulated here. They last ran in 1957 in Sydney. My G-scale or 1-gauge models are fitted with power bogies by Pittman and the Risto. This model represents the class leader of the W6 type tram car in Melbourne, the first tram to receive power operated sliding doors. The W6 and the later W7, which the later cars all had slightly altered windows, they can be seen today doing the Free City Circle in Melbourne. This particular model can actually be seen in an Australian movie called Malcolm. Here are more recent acquisitions, a couple of Sydney electric suburban cars were commonly called Red Rattlers these days, Bradfields, originally converted from steam stock, very early operators on the Sydney Electric Suburban Railways. And if you can bear with me, because I'm going to hold the camera with one hand and turn the Sydney destination roll around a little for you to see the unique coloured symbols, which were of enormous benefit to identify your tram car in the distance. And it was a wonderful way of identifying trams to the distant pointsmen, called switchmen in the States, to reset the points in their boxes quite a distance away from the next tram arrival. Birch Grove, which is near the suburb of Balmain in Sydney. These are the various destinations where I grew up. And one of the better known suburbs in Sydney, Balmain. In some of the other areas of Sydney, the southwestern lines, most of the symbols were green, as were some of the eastern suburbs. Okay, we made it. I hand-built this unique set of Sydney tram cars in half-inch to the foot scale. This could be the only coupling of an O-class with an OP in model form in this scale on the planet. To see the two different types in multiple unit was a rare sight on Sydney streets, because the OP class, numbered 12, in the city's fleet of some 1,500 trams.